Hello, everyone. Today, we're back with some really interesting news. First, we cover how all the companies are competing for the emerging market of space tourism, and then some updates from Germany. So, let's start. A new industry is slowly keeping its pieces together, and that time is not too far when this industry will create its own place with value more than billions. Yes, we're talking about the space tourism industry that's continuously growing like an unstoppable force that wants to pass every obstacle in its path. Up till now, many thought about this industry as a science fiction or hard only on space storybooks. But it's now close to becoming a reality, with several aerospace companies competing with each other to take the lead in this emerging market. However, not everything would be as easy as it said. We still cannot confirm what impact it will create as a billion-dollar business and how much a space trip will cost. Will it be affordable to regular civilians? Now, these factors depend on a company's technological capabilities. As an example, we know companies like Virgin Galactic and SpaceX are competing with each other to take the lead, and both are planning to fly private customers to space next year, but there will be different options based on space trips for both companies. Another important factor is the destination of the space flights. It depends on whether people want to go on a suborbital or an orbital space tour. In a space trip, the total cost and experiences one might have changes based on the destination. It also changes the risks that would take place during space travel. According to a report, in future, space tourism could make a market value of $3 billion with both of its orbital and suborbital space trips. Previously, space industry consultancy Northern Sky Research stated that by the year 2028, a suborbital space tour market is expected to make around $2.8 billion, while an orbital market could make $610 million in this industry. But again, all this is just a prediction based on current sources. To be more specific, we have to talk about these suborbital and orbital space trips in detail and how the competing companies are making progress in this growing industry. In the case of suborbital tourism, currently there are two companies that are competing head-to-head. One is the British spaceflight company, Virgin Galactic, which debuted on the public market in 2019, aims to provide suborbital space flights for space tourism. Another one is Blue Origin, the rival company of Virgin Galactic in the suborbital industry. Almost the entire funding of this private space company comes from Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos' pocket. Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin only had one similarity in case of suborbital flights. That's both companies could fly up to 6 passengers per flight, although Virgin Galactic's suborbital spacecraft has an additional seat for one extra pilot. The passengers have to train for 3 days before stepping inside the spaceflight. The British space company has a jet-powered carrier aircraft named White Knight 2 attached to the spaceship, which could reach an altitude of 40,000 feet. Before returning to New Mexico's runway, the spacecraft will offer a backflip at the edge of space in which passengers can experience a few minutes floating in the micro-G environment. The British spacecraft could be reusable by just replacing the hybrid rocket engine. On the other side, Blue Origin's New Shepard spacecraft looks more like a traditional rocket with a domed capsule on top of the 60-foot tall booster. The capsule, in which passengers will be on board, gets separated from the rocket to reach an altitude of 333,000 feet, about 10 kilometers from the ground. After floating for a few minutes in the microgravity, the capsule will return to Earth, with a batch of parachutes slowing it down while landing on the desert floor in West Texas. Blue Origin's New Shepard also has a reusable booster. Up till now, Virgin Galactic has launched 2 test flights, although both flights include its own company employees. The company is planning 2 more test flights, along with a flight on board with the founder of the company, Richard Branson, which is scheduled for 2021. On the other hand, apart from completing several launch missions in the past few years, Blue Origin hasn't flown any passenger flights. The company said it would need 2 or 3 test flights before flying actual passenger flights. Virgin Galactic previously sold each ticket for a price of $200,000 to $250,000 for its suborbital space flights, although the company expects it could increase more in coming years. Blue Origin CEO Jeff Bezos hasn't declared any pricing yet. There's a chance that Virgin Galactic space tourism will further increase as the price comes down a bit. Globally, we think around 2 million people can experience this over the coming years at this price point. Over time, we'll be able to reduce that price point, and at that point, the market just explodes. It's 10 times as many at 40 million people, Virgin Galactic Chief Space Officer Whitesides stated last year. In these suborbital space flights, which are limited to a certain height, about 100 kilometers or 330,000 feet, passengers could spend only a few minutes in space. However, in an orbital spaceflight, it could reach over 400 kilometers or 1.3 million feet, with passengers spending even a week and enjoy the mesmerizing view of space. Elon Musk's private aerospace company, SpaceX, has already made its name in this industry with its Falcon 9 rocket and Dragon crew flights. In this year, SpaceX successfully launched and landed the Demo 2, which included two NASA astronauts. Because of this historic test, flight program SpaceX became the first private company to send astronauts to orbit. SpaceX's rocket launch system is kind of like Blue Origin's, but it offers a more powerful rocket with a larger capsule. Despite having a big-sized capsule, SpaceX didn't compromise on the interior of the capsule. Demo 2 NASA astronauts said itself, SpaceX capsule is a little bit smoother than its previous spacecraft. Apart from Demo 2, SpaceX already has two separate passenger flight contracts in their hand. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk didn't declare how much these contracts are worth yet. The company previously stated these private missions would have duration of 10 days with a cost of $50 million for each person for riding in Crew Dragon. SpaceX also has its next generation Starship, which are currently in the development stage. It's the center attraction in Musk's vision of sending people to Mars. After the completion of Starship, it probably will be the best option for orbital space travel. However, SpaceX isn't the only company that offers orbital space flights. The American multinational corporation, Boeing, is developing its Starliner to send people in space. Boeing already has a contract with NASA to fly four astronauts, although there's an extra seat currently preserved for a space tourist. This will be a beginning for Boeing to crave its own name in the orbital spaceflight industry. Like those well-known names of the industry, there are some startup companies that want to send people into space. Maybe some of these companies don't build or launch an orbital rocket, but they provide all the necessities that an orbital mission requires. As an example, the Houston-based startup Axiom Space Company signed a contract with NASA and SpaceX to fly a trained astronaut along with three passengers to the International Space Station that's scheduled on October 21st, 2020. Now it's time for some news from Germany. Germany's renowned Augsburg AG, RFA, rocket factory recently signed a Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, with another rocket surface provider, Andøya Space, which is based in Norway. The contract is to implement a launch site for the RFA-1 launch system to provide small sat launch services. In that regard, Chief Operation Officer of RFA, Dr. Stefan Brieschenk, stated, "This partnership is pivotal. It allows RFA and Andøya to launch the first satellite into orbit from continental Europe with a European launcher." Norway-based Andøya Space, which has more than 50 years of experience in suborbital rocket programs, is developing its new launch complex on an island that's 35 kilometers south from its current suborbital launch site. After the completion, Andøya Space will have two active launch pads. With this new site, there will be some advantages, like providing a 1.5-ton payload class with independent integration facilities, etc. On the other hand, Augsburg AG, RFA, rocket factory is basically a startup company, which is developing the RFA-1 launcher system. This system will launch small satellites to lower Earth orbit. According to the sources, its first satellite launch is scheduled to take place in 2022. The rocket factory receives a lot of support from German satellite manufacturing company, OHB. Recently, the company passed a cryogenic test for its upper stage tank system, and is now preparing for a hot fire test for the RFA stage combustion engine. This test will take place starting from October 2020 in Esrange, Sweden. The CEO and president of Andøya Space, Odd Roger Onnixon, said some words during MOU was signed. "We are convinced that Rocket Factory is one of the most progressive SSLV companies in Europe. Having them commit to Andoya Space as a partner is of great significance to us. We're developing an efficient multi-user launch site in Norway, and Rocket Factory has the technical capabilities, the same innovative culture, and the enthusiastic team we need in a partner to help us take the spaceport initiative forward. We look forward to supporting them in their missions to polar and sun synchronous orbits." Augsburg Rocket Factory's powerful stage combustion engine is coupled to lowest possible cost production techniques and is also new to Europe. With the help of German-based OHB, the Rocket Factory has secured key technologies and key talent that will significantly improve the business. It will open a path for the Rocket Factory to build a powerful and efficient rocket engine technology in Europe. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.